up, y'all?
It's us again.
Hey.
And so what we want to talk about today is the acronym is PMCS, and it stands for Preventative Maintenance Checks and Services.
Yeah, it's basically how you keep something running efficiently and effectively.
Yeah.
And so we're going to keep it 100 with y'all on this one because we're not so good at this.
So
basically this is that check-in that you're supposed to have with each other.
Yeah, you right? know, rather than being reactive and waiting for there to be a fire and then, you know, working overtime to put out a fire that you could have put out if you would have implemented this preventative maintenance checks and services.
Yeah.
If we had implemented something like that, we could have avoided a lot of issues that we had.
I asked my wife a couple times, you know, it was one of our kids would say, are you happy at me? You know, basically he was trying to say, are you happy with me?
Right.
And he said, are you DJ. Happy at me?
Are you happy
and I used to mommy? Say that kind of jokingly, because I actually really didn't want to know if she was happy with me. Or actually I wanted her to be happy with me, but I knew she wasn't. So I ain't asked the question. And so some of the brothers out there probably feel like me, you know, because you know you ain't doing what you're supposed to do, so you don't even want to ask the question because you know your wife ain't happy, you know. So, you know, we got to get over them fears, because at the end of the day, you know, it's like when you take your car to get fixed. I mean, if you don't know that something's wrong with the car and all of a sudden, you know, your check engine light come on, you know, I mean, you don't take it to the shop and all of a sudden your engine lock up.
Exactly. And now you got a real big problem when it could have just been an oil change or something like that. And so, you know, or there'll be times where Teddy has been, you know, asking me, is everything all right? And I'm like, yep, I'm good. First of all, when a woman does this, yep, I'm good. She lying.
She not good.
She lying. And so what happens is him avoiding conversation, you know, us lying, we ain't getting nowhere.
Yeah.
So we could just be having a little bit of an oil check problem that turns into a completely locked up engine. Now you got to spend all this time, money, energy, and effort on something that you could have. You could have done something more preventative to avoid completely. So we want to encourage y'all, talk, y'all.
Yeah.
Talk.
Check
like,
in.
We ain't been that good at that throughout our relationship. I talk too much. Teddy ain't talked enough. Like,
talk too little.
You know, so like, you know, it, you know, we're getting better at that and finding the balance of it now. But we weren't good at that. And we didn't understand, like, if you don't have communication, you don't have anything. Your relationship is coming to a screeching halt at some point in time. There's going to be hardness. There's going to be walls. You'll be 20 years in realizing, like, we ain't really got nothing. Why? Because ain't nobody really talking about the stuff that needs to be discussed. And so...
Preventative.
It's preventative.
Maintenance. Checks. And services.
It's
so, like,
necessary.
In the title, it's telling you how to prevent it.
How to prevent it.
You know, preventative maintenance, right? So, I'm gonna do some work, you know, to prevent, you know, the accident, right? So the work I'm going to do is to check in, right?
Exactly.
Checks and services. And, you know, once I check, I actually got to do something about it. If that engine light is on,
exactly,
I actually got to do something about it. So that's where the service comes in.
This service is not functioning the way it should. I got to go in there and service it. So you guys, whatever you do, talk to each other.
Yeah.
Be honest with each other. If you avoid it, facing it later could create a much bigger problem.
Yeah.
Don't avoid talking to her because she's hard to talk to. Tell her, baby, I want to talk to you, but you real hard to talk to. Like, tell me what's the best time and the best way to talk to you.
Mm-hmm.
And you tell your husband, I want you to be interested in what I'm saying. So how can I talk in a way that makes you hear me, or that makes you even desire to hear me? Because I really do want us. Like, I want this love, but I'm not really good at talking to you in a way that you can hear, you know? And we learned that through these preventative conversations that we began to implement.
Yeah.
So that's what you got to do. You got to have some, you got to check in, man. You got to check in and be honest.
Yeah.
Make sure you ain't finna have a locked up engine when you could have just got an oil change.
Bye, y'all. Hope this was helpful.
Yeah.